Glamis Castle is one of the most haunted castles in Great Britain, and is very famous throughout the world. Visitors have reported seeing ghost-like apparitions walking down the halls, as well as experiencing other strange paranormal phenomena. One visitor, Sir Walter, who stayed in the castle in 1790, stated, "I must own, as I heard door after door shut after my conductor had retired, I began to consider myself as too far from the living and somewhat too near to the dead." One of the first ghosts that was believed to walk these dark halls is Lady Janet Douglas. Lady Janet was burned at the stake, accused of witchcraft in 1537, after it was believed that she had poisoned her husband. And it is said that on dark and stormy nights, she can be seen by visitors walking throughout the castle. Now, these ghost sightings have been going on for hundreds of years, but it's not just the ghost sightings that makes this castle famous. There are stories of people encountering a monster. One story tells of a man who was working in the castle when he found a hidden door that led to a secret passage. So he decided to explore it. And while he was walking, he saw something human-like moving at the far end of the passage, and he was scared to death. So he ran out of there as fast as he could, and he told the groundskeeper. And the next day, he was fired. And the Earl, the owner of the castle, paid him to move to Australia. So if this story is true, this man saw something that he wasn't supposed to see. Now, the monster of Glamis has been described as looking like a human toad. Several witnesses have sworn to have seen the creature throughout the years, but sightings are extremely rare. Now, it is believed that this very powerful family, who has royalty in their blood, has a dark secret, and only three people are allowed to know it at one time. The Earl, the Earl's heir once he or she comes to age, and the estate manager. And many believe that this secret has something to do with the monster. Many years ago, a writer claimed that he was told that in this castle, there is a secret chamber, and in this chamber, there is a monster who is a rightful heir to the title and property. But he is so hideous that it's necessary to keep him out of sight and out of possession of the family estate. Some believe that this secret has something to do with a legend that happened in the 15th century. It is said that the second Lord of Glamis loved to gamble, and on Sabbath, he invited the other noble lords to join him. But they refused because it was Sabbath. So Lord Glamis told them, "I don't care if it's Sabbath, I will play cards until doomsday or with the devil himself." And legend has it, later that night, a stranger, the devil, appeared at the castle's door wanting to play cards. And in the end, Lord Glamis ended up betting his soul, and he lost. And in this room, somewhere deep within the castle, he was dragged to hell. And shortly after, this room was sealed up, because it was now a gateway or a portal to hell. A very creepy legend indeed. Now, I doubt we will ever know what the secret was, but I do find it very plausible that there was once a child who was so deformed that the family felt that it was best for them to hide it somewhere deep in the castle for the rest of its life, which is very sad. Another story I wanted to cover today is an alleged encounter with the Owlman of Cornwall that went viral a couple of weeks ago. Sightings of the Owlman of Cornwall have been reported for almost 100 years, and I have covered this before. And what made the Owlman famous worldwide is the mass sightings that happened in 1976, and pretty much all the sightings of the Owlman have occurred near a church. Now, there have been tons of investigations at this location in hopes of spotting this creature, and a couple of weeks ago, a ghost hunter, Mark Davis and his team, claimed to have filmed something that kind of looked like the Owlman. In the footage, which I'll link below, Mark was investigating the graveyard of the church, and when he was panning the camera, he asked if any creature lives here. Then, in the corner of the frame, you can see something standing there, staring at these ghost hunters. And when they went to go investigate, there was nothing there. It just vanished. Now, I do find this footage interesting, and it is definitely very creepy. And to my knowledge, nobody has ever gotten any footage or any evidence at all of the Owlman of Cornwall, despite dozens of what seem to be very credible eyewitnesses. Now, whatever the case may be, real or a hoax, this alleged encounter is going to help fuel the Owlman hysteria that has been going on in this town for the past 100 years. And I would like to know, what do you guys think of this footage? Until next time, this is Paranormal Junkie. Make sure to hit that subscribe button and stay tuned.